got it. Your heart, I want it. I know you want me. So just sit back and enjoy it. We are young, we got it. Your heart, I want it. I know you want me. So just sit back and enjoy it. Ooh.
We are going to be talking about the dating scene compared, the dating scene in Kenya compared with the dating scene in America. Nyumbani kuna vile watu huelewana. The rules of engagement are very, very similar. You'd go to a club, you'd meet someone, and after you text her the next day, it's nothing awkward. Ni kama something passed. You could feel like something passed. I feel like in America, for instance, unless it's overtly said, kesho yake by the day you can text, alafu apparently it wasn't
heavy.
Economia naita exit strategy.
Exit strategy. Pia mtapita napo nje. Yes, you were together the night before, but now.
Ni more formal, like dating ni more formal. Like msia nakwambia, oh twende out, naenda out na Joanna and all that. Kenya, unaongea na Charlie siku moja umeshakuwa dem.
Exit strategy.
ati uyundo bibi.
Lazima
mtu unini uarticulate intentions
yako.
Tuongea tuongea hadi siku gani? Tunasaidiana aje? Wakenya wanakuongelesha lakini hawavoko. Like utasikia alikuwa na dem. Alikuwa na dem wa 2 years, wa 3 years. Hapo hapo unadhani wewe ndo bibi.
What do I put on you? Serious, my friend.
By the time
the other day, the other day, you know, some of these things are confidential, but I had to fly. My friend. Like week two, Wazazo was charged to you, my friend.
Kenya, I get your perspective. Like, kuna machali ko anta ka waone what's out there before wa. But besides, India. Lakini shida ni hawambi dem. Unafanya dem adhanie ni yeye peke yake. Una mshrik. Unasema it's just wait, dem hajui una date other people. Alafu una mtu asko ndio anasema by then. Najua nilikuwa na date wewe na nani
na nani.
Wana involve family, wana involve mabeshte, manani. Lakini Kenya, before family wako involved, hey, lazima utakuwa umelipa mahari.
Sikatai.
Lakini machali wa Kenya huwa huko.
Nasema machali wa Kenya.
Nasema huwa huko. Watavocalize, watakwambia. Anyaye kwa tu venye hii, I see serious.
And that's fine. The chida tu ni vocalize, just like useme.
Aya, useme mitutu hii swali basi. Kama mwanamke, this is just your personal opinion, lakini. Would you, kama boy anaza kushuru, endaya hapa, strike you to long term, taka kitu short term? Is it, utafili kama you being degraded, ni kama anafikiria yoyo ni chipo funga hapo?
Apana, ina depend na what you want. Mimi sijali kama pia unataka short term, okay. But kama you want something long term, then tunamwambia no. Lakini kama ina, I think ina depend, everyone is different.
Yeah,
kama you want the same thing, sawa. But sisi kuna mtu anataka the same thing.
Na sisi watoto identify kama wanaume na wanawake, tutafanya nini?
Yeah, by the way, gender non-binary, kuna mtu hapo anarepresent your community on a serious note.
Ezekiel Mutua akisikia hiyo neno. Ezekiel Mutua atabana.
Maneno ya Patrick yanatengeneza. Anata, Ezekiel atakisikia. Gender non-binary,
I have seen this culture perpetuated by the boys' schools. It is okay to have non-sexual and romantic relationships.
Platonic relationships.
Treat them as friends.
That's true. Yeah. We don't. I don't think we emphasize the possibility for platonic relationships between a guy.
Yeah. The idea that unambiwa or in a growing your mind that the other like girls or boys are just for sexual. I mean,
Kabisa.
Just for romantic relationships.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you can't you can't have a friendship with a person of opposite sex without it being a romantic.
Consent is a perpetual thing. You know, not just sexual consent, but you have consent to remain in a relationship in that particular way. So, if you see the situations that you have to say, you can't get a little bit of 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 a little
bit of
So it's possible for you to tell yourself or like to think that I'm having this friendship with this person and I don't want it to lead elsewhere. And also something that can help is just communication.
Communication.
Just tell the other person that or communicate and say I want this because I want a romantic relationship or I want this because I want a friendship.
That's true.
I feel like US, like women are more open compared to Kenya, you know. And I feel like even in schools, like Kenya ukienda shule, they don't tell you, you don't have this conversation.
Yeah, that's true.
So the thing is like, as a person, you are kind of more, you want to venture out and see what you're not told.
Yeah,
so like, you don't talk about sex, you're told sex, you know, all that stuff.
That's
so that's how like, people that's think curious. That they should do that, you know? Like the way the mind, you know, the way like mind people's mind works, is like, you t- tell them do not do this, yeah. They wanna do it. So that's how Kenyan mind, like in Kenya, wali wanakuambia ati nini, ati story, watch my friend nani, ati, you know, it's like, how is the relationship? Like, it's a no-no. Machali na madem wakianza kuinteract, it's just like very sexual because like that's all you want to think about because that's what you've been told not to think.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah. And I mean, even in primary school.
No.
If you had just a normal friendship with a person,
that was already an issue.
It was already an issue because teachers would be like, oh, you're having a relationship and you're too young to have a relationship.
Yeah,
even if it's just a
person. Okay. But yeah. Make a staff from your channel.
So there's generally more access to information about safe sex.
Yeah.
Like information about, you know, romantic relationships and how to get over a breakup. But I may do this when you're young. Now from today you can date. You know, it's a very green line.
You've been a financial in a from 0 to 100.
Like these kinds of conversations, even if we're talking about, you know, safe sex, if we're talking about, you know, whether or not the argument for prostitution for life is to be talked about in the Kenyan context. First, kama ni high school ama kama ni university, like, you know, we know exactly when to start having this conversation.
We are human beings and we are going to, people are going to be in relationships, people are going to have sexual intercourse. Like, yeah, these are things that are going to happen because we're human beings. So we need to start, like as you said, have open conversations, talk about safe sex, talk about things that people go through during dating, so that you have more of a like preparation before we get into the dating scene.
Sometimes I'm a bit less prepared, you know, to get into the dating scene in America. Because like the norms in Kenya were a bit too heavily skewed to favor Baliane, the guys in a dating society.
Yeah.
Rona.
Ati women should be over men. Tunaongea kuhusu kuna issues in a face madame, lazima tu address. And then matata anakuja, oh, men,
I'm just agreeing with that.
So I want to take you, one of the problems, one of the consistencies in your, if you don't get kuhusu kwenye, like, madame apa wako more direct, pia inakuanga na ile narrative ya the female child, imekuwa imekanagiwa story chini ya maji. So design nye, like hata mimi nikiwa Kenya, nikiwa high school, ilikuwa design umefika age, expectation, so the society saying, yeah, sasa unafai kwa nile process kumbisha madame. Lakini hakuna ile expectation ya madame wanafai kwa wanataka
kuongea na wewe.
That's it. Yeah. So wao hata kwa fangi ukienda nile inakuwa ati, eh, wewe uliongea na madame ngapi? Haikwangi? Uliongea na madame ngapi kwa consent?
Eh, kabisa. Ama madame ngapi walikuongelesha
wewe?
Eh,
banda. Bado unaona kwa nini umejibongesha kama umeenda?
Dante ameongea kwa sababu.
You guys think it's more expensive to date a woman in States or in Kenya?
A Kenyan woman will ever tell you put your wallet away and you make that in
an empowered Kenyan woman.
An empowered Kenyan woman.
Empowered Kenyan woman.
How many empowered Kenyan women do you know?
There are so many, but do you date them?
No. Yeah.
Below the belt.